So we are taking a look at the awards Birdman and his brother Slim just received and the speech Birdman gave at the event. They were given a YouTube Leaders and Legends Award, and Birdman went all the way back to remind the audience why he and his brother deserve this recognition. Let's check it out.
I kept them in the studio because they was very young for like 2-3 years. And if you keep any lion, tiger, bear in the studio, when you let in a cage, when you let them out, they're gonna attack. And when I let them out, they was young, they was about 14. They attacked the world, right? By then, we signed out a deal with UMG. Dino DeValle came down. We brought him in our project, and that what made me go to UMG, and we signed with him. But at the same time, that was a genre of music that we blew up in. It was hard for people right then. It was heavy back then. It was real heavy. Everybody was doing their thing, but I let them youngsters out the cage. Juvie was already sharp, but Wayne, DG, Shorty, they was getting sharp because I kept them in the studio for years, every day of my life, right? So at this point, I just wanted to get them out the streets and save their life. So I made the studio our streets. And by then, by the time they're 15, 16, they ain't know nothing but the studio. So it couldn't even, if they tried to function different, it was already remotely to me that they needed to do it in the studio. So after a while, we blew up and Katrina happened. And we had some differences before Katrina. Some came, some left, and Katrina happened. I always was tight with Wayne. He always, you know, I was a father like to all of them, to be honest. Like, cause I was like, their mama gave them to me to raise them. Cause they was heading in different directions. New Orleans at this time, we was the murder capital. So die like at any time, at any minute, any second, that's what it was. So when I got the chance to be with them a lot and put them in the studio a lot, by the time they were teenagers, nothing mattered more to them than but the studio, because I did it to them at like 11, 12 years old. So after Katrina, I went to Texas. Wayne went to Miami, and he called me. He told me to come to Miami. So I went to Miami, and we became like, we was already close, but we came closer than ever, because we was like, it's me, you, and Slim, and we gonna do this. And with all due respect to Jay-Z, I remember he said, he retired, and Wayne shot a video said, since the best rapper retired, I'm the best rapper alive. And a lot of changed for us from that moment, but at the same time, saying hip hop is dead. We Southern, we don't know nothing about that type of shit, but this all we got is hip hop. You understand? So when saying hip hop is dead, we like, honestly like, what the f*** are they talking about, you heard me? We ain't know nothing about that type of shit. We felt like this our time to just take over hip hop. That's when the birth of Young Money came, Nicki and Drake came, and we kind of held hip hop down, right? When saying it was dead, we felt like we was bringing it back to life, and we did that. We did that soulfully, and if, you know, you saw the artists, and a lot of artists that we birthed, I could name a lot of them, a whole bunch of them that we made millionaires. At this point, we just thinking about surviving. We survived the warfare in New Orleans, now we're surviving in life.
If you have stayed with me to this point of the video, consider subscribing, hit the like button, and leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.